lugar, good afternoon sa ibang lugar. Lahat ng good, ayan. Ayan, sino pa ba po nasa front side. And we welcome to all our online, team online, team bahay, and team online. You are so welcome here, and we are so glad that you tapped that live stream. Amen. And to all our on-site friends, family, welcome and good afternoon, everyone. Are you happy? Masaya ba kayo? It's another Sunday to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Prayer. Let's acknowledge the presence of the Lord. I invite everyone, let's all stand and let's close our eyes and invite the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for this wonderful afternoon. Salamat, Lord, sa isang week na naman, O God, ang natapos. And we are so grateful that you guide us throughout the week at nakarating po kami dito sa place na ito at nakapanood po kami ng live na ito. Oh God, to be refreshed once again, to be revived once again. Oh God, Lord, we are so excited. Lord, sabik po kami na makikita ang bawat isa to worship you, to sing for you, oh God, with all these brothers and sisters. Hallelujah, Jesus, for in unity, for when we dwell together in your presence, in your temple, Lord, with unity, ay nandyan ka po sa amin, oh God. You are in the midst of us. So right now, oh God, we just wanna thank you with a grateful heart. We just wanna praise you with a humble heart, oh God. Lord, here are your people. We are so excited. Open our eyes. Open our hearts. For we are so ready to what you're going to wanted us to receive for this afternoon, oh God. Lord, let it be na sa lahat pa po na paparating for all our brothers and sisters who are still coming, oh God. Lord, guide their footsteps. Lord, send millions of angels be with them as they're going to come here in this place with an expectant heart to praise you, oh God, and to be filled with your Holy Spirit. Lord, huwag niyo pong hayaan na aalis ang inyong mga anak na hindi po sila punong-puno, na hindi po sila, oh God, na napupuno ng inyong presensya, ng inyong mga salita that comes from you alone, oh God. Hallelujah, Lord, we are so excited. Lord, sabik na po kami, oh God, na maranasan ang inyong presensya, oh God, sa oras na ito. Lord, let your will be done, let your kingdom come here in this place. And Lord, send millions, cover this place with your holy presence, oh God. This four corners of this church and every four corners of every rooms that who are watching right now, oh God. Lord, salamat. Patuloy niyo pong samahan ang bawat isa. Lord, to you be all the glory, the honor, and the adoration and the thanksgiving. To you alone, we love you, Jesus, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Excited po ba ang lahat? Come on, can you tell your seatmate or katabi na I am so glad you are here. Natutuwa ba talaga? Or napipilitan? Okay, so sabi dito sa Exodus 15:2, ayan, sabi dito ng mga Israelites, ayan, sabi nila dito na, the Lord is my strength and my song. Ayan, totoo ba? The Lord is your strength and your song? Agree, disagree? Hindi sila agree, pero agree, amen po. He has given me victory. Ayan, sino mga victorious sa oras na ito? Amen, amen. This is my God and I will praise Him. Amen. My Father's God and I will exalt Panginoon po bang victorious again dito sa oras na ito. Amen. Amen. Pumalakpak ng malakas. Hallelujah. Come on, let's sing for joy to the Lord. Come on, clap your hands, church.
We're gonna shout!
Thank you, Lord God, for this wonderful opportunity to praise you freely. Hallelujah. Come on, church, just be in the presence of the Lord today. We talk about vision for this month. And right now, may we have that desire to see what God sees. Not by our own perspective, but by God's perspective. Because we tend to see things that are so limited. That's why we are discouraged. We are disappointed. But right now, church, let faith arise. Let faith arise here in this place. Let faith arise in every hearts right now. But Lord, I want to see what you see in my life. The great things, the great plans that you have for me. Hallelujah. Lord, I want to see your glory. I want to be closer to your heart, oh God. Sing this.
Savior of my soul, I worship you as God alone. Greater love has made a way to open my heart, open my heart.
That you have in store for each one's lives, that who are here and who are watching in our live stream. Lord Father, let your kingdom come and your will be done in this place and every lives who will be reaching in this live stream and everyone who are here on site. Lord, we thank you, Father. We give you all the glory, the adoration, the praises, the thanksgiving. We love you, Jesus. To you be the glory in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. Lord. Good afternoon sa aking mga kapatiran. Oh my God. This is my first time to stand up here. For how many long I'm staying here in Canada. Ninenervyos ako kayo. Kaya nga hindi ako pumunta noong next week. Kasi sabi ni Pastora, ikaw magtatayo. Una ko po, Diyos ko Lord. Hindi ko alam. But anyway, kaninang umaga, nagising ako ng 5:30. Sabi ko, pupunta ba ako mag-church? Ayokong magsalita doon sa harapan ng tablado. Ayun, pinabasa sa akin ni Lord itong Corinthians 9, chapter 9, verse 6, 8. Pero babasahin ko lang yung chapter 9, verse 6. Ito yung salita ng Diyos. But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. And he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Bountifully. Ngunit, sabi nga dito, yung but he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. So ang nagasik ng kaunti ay mag-aani din ng kaunti. So ang pagkakaintindi ko rito, tayo as a Christian, kung taos sa puso natin ang pananambahan sa ating Panginoon Diyos, ito yung na-experience. I-share ko lang yung experience ko sa inyo dito sa Canada. Actually, when I came here in Canada, I'm a tourist. Marami akong bahay. Yun ang kabutihan na pag nasa Panginoong Diyos ka. Ito, honestly, tututo, nandiyan ang Panginoong Diyos. Umalis ako sa Pilipinas, mahirap ang buhay sa Pilipinas. Anim ang anak ko, nawalan ako ng trabaho sa government, so what I need to do, I need to go out the Philippines. Marami akong utang. So, pumunta ko rito, wala akong kakilala dito. Pero sa Panginoong Diyos, salamat ako sa Kanya. Marami akong different organization of church. Nanamit ko, in-invite nila ako doon. Ang dami kong bahay, hindi ako nagbabayad, dahil ayaw nila akong pagbayarin. So nakaraos ako sa ganon. And then, naalaala ko yung ginagawa ko sa Pilipinas na pag magsasaing ako, kukuha ko ng isang dakot nung sa kaldero, itatabi ko. Yung itinatabi ko, yun din ang iniluluto ko para may pagkain sa church. So, dinala ko yun dito. Imagine, nung dumating ako rito, ang minimum pa lang noon is $6 an hour. So, ilan ang anak ko doon, kailangan kong padalahan. Alam yung honest to goodness. Ang laman ng backpack ko, saging at tubig. Dahil gusto kong magtipid dahil mag-fellowship ako ulit. The following week. So, kailangan may ibigay ako kay Lord. Kasi ang church, oo, meron tayong pastor, pero ang church hindi naman kayang tugunan ng pastor. So, parang magulang. Ang magulang, marami kang anak dyan, alam mo kung anong pangangailangan ng mga anak mo. So, ganun ang ginagawa ko. So, more than 3 to 4 years. Oh, 3 to 4 years. No, 2 to 3 years. Itipid ko yung sarili ko, pero sa Panginoon Diyos, sa awa ng Panginoon Diyos, hindi ko naramdaman ang mawala ng pera. Hindi ko rin naramdaman na bumili ako ng damit. Yung taong mag-invite sa akin sa church tuwing Pasko, hindi ko man sila kikilala. Sister, eto ang damit mo. Bibigyan ako ng damit na bago, yung pang winter, dahil naranasan kong tumayo sa isang waiting shed, first time na mag-winter, giniginawa ko, wala akong pangginaw. Gusto ko magpayakap dun sa isang mama, pero nahihiya ako. Yan ang totoo. Sabi ko, Lord, na tulungan mo ako, giniginaw na ako, nagpipreasing na ako. So yun, may tinuluyan ako sa Brampton na hindi ko na anong kasi malapit sa kamag-anak. Hindi nila ako kinuha nung gabing yun. Sana ako matutulog. May nakilala ko sa bus stop. Ang Panginoong Diyos, naniniwala kong pagtapat ka sa Panginoong Diyos, huwag mong intindihin kung anong sasabihin ng iba. Ang intindihin mo yung relasyon ninyong dalawa. Basta maging tapat ka, ibigay mo yung para sa Kanya. Hindi ka mawawalan. Nung gabing yun, wala akong matutulugan. Lord, kako, saan ako matutulog ngayong gabi? Ang lamig-lamig. May isang babae na doon. Sabi niya, sis, may sundo ka ba? Oo, kaya lang hindi na yata darating. Dahil 10:30 na ng gabi, mawawala na ng biyahe ng mga bus. So, madalit salita, inuwi niya ako doon sa bahay nila. So, doon ako natulog na magdami hanggang binigyan ako ng part-time. Sumunod na naman, nagtatrabaho ko, umuulan. Hinintuan ako ng isang van. Punong-puno ng ang mata nila namumula. Ang sabi ko, Lord, ano ito? Niya, bumaba sila, isasakay nila ako doon. Pero may biglang dumating na isang lalaki na parang Pilipino. Sabi ko, Lord, kako, tumakbo ko, sabi ko, Lord, forgive me, kako. Honey, bakit ngayon ka lang napatingin yung mga tao? So ngayon, hindi nila ako na sinasabi ko, parang awa mo na, samahan mo ako, bumalik tayo sa Motel 6 kasi doon ako nagtatrabaho. Bumalik kami ng Motel 6, yung ng management nagdala sa akin doon. Kaya kahit na wala akong pera sa bulsa, pamasahe ko na lang, hindi baling tubig lang panangalian ko, basta yung sa Panginoong Diyos. At sa ngayon, sa edad ko na ito, awa ng Diyos. Kailangan mo ng pera, huwag ka magsabi sa tao, kay Lord ka bibigay. Kailangan mo, kayong mga anak ko, kailangan ng mga anak ko nang papunta rito ng siyong money para student. May nagbigay sa akin $40,000. Sino sa atin na magbibigay ng $40,000 sa isang taong? Binigyan ako ng $40,000, pinagkatiwalaan ako ng taong ko, pinadala ko sa Pilipinas. Ang pera, basta maging tapat ka lang sa Kanya, hindi mo hahanapin. Kusang lalabas yan, yun lang masasabi ko. So, eto yung gustong-gusto kong ano na, huwag kang maging maramot. Pag nababasa ko to, naalala ko yung nakaraan ko, na lahat ng pinaghirapan ko, kaya ang pera mula nang dumating ako rito, hindi ako namang problema. Sabi, hindi ko naman sinasabi na mapera ako. Pero kung anong wala ako noon, mas tripling inabot niya sa akin ngayon. Ano ang sikreto? Ibigay mo yung para sa Kanya. Yun lang ang masasabi ko. Ito sa, ano ba to, sa kawikaan. Ang isang tao ay nagbibigay ng malaya. Ngunit nakakakuha pa ng higit. Nalalim to, pag nagbibigay daw tayo sa tao, sa taong ating pinibigyan, lalo na sa ating Panginoon Diyos, mas higit ang ibabalik sa iyo. Yun ang pagka na nabasa ko to kanina, talaga napaiyak ako. Ngunit nakakakuha pa ang higit ng isa pa ay nagtitimpi ng labis. Ibig sabihin nito, kung ikaw may pera ka o may pagbabayaran ako, may aano ko, parang titipirin mo yung Panginoon, titipirin ka rin niya. Yun ang pagkakaintindi ko rito. Magbigay ka ng malaya at maging mas mayaman, maging kuripot at talo. Yun ang sa kawikaan. Kung ibig sabihin, pag nagbigay ka, yung taong sa puso mo, dahil ang Diyos ang magbabalik sa'yo. Pero kung naging kuripot ka, ano ay naasahan mo? Di ba wala? At huwag mong sabihin na binigyan ka, ang Panginoon Diyos gumagamit ng tao para bigyan ka. Yun lang ang masasabi. Salamat sa Panginoon Diyos. Mananalangin tayo. O kabanal-banalang Diyos na makapangyarihan sa lahat, na siyang may likha ng langit at lupa. Sa pangalan ng bugtong mong anak na si Jesus at ng Holy Spirit, narito po ang inyong abanlinggo. Nagpapasalamat po ko, Panginoon, bagkat wala akong nalid sa araw na ito, Panginoon. Hindi mo kami pinabayaan. Ama, itinataas ko ang lahat nang ika po na ibibigay ng aking mga kapatiran na dapat lamang po, Panginoon, ibalik namin sa iyo upang ang iyong salita ay lumaganap, Panginoon. At wala kaming magagawa kung wala ka sa amin. Sa tulong mo, Panginoon, saan kami ay umaasa. Wala kaming trabaho, ngunit sa iyong gabay, ibinibigay mo ang trabaho ng libre. para saan ba ito, Panginoon? Kaya salamat po, Diyos, at nawa, Panginoon, pagpalain mo ang bawat isa sa amin at ang mga taong walang trabaho, ay bigyan mo sila ng pagkakakitaan upang sila, Panginoon, ay makapagsulit sa iyo. At kung sino man, Panginoon, ang narito, Panginoon, na may karamdaman, tinataas ko rin sa iyo, nabigyan mo ng kumpletong kagalingan upang siya makapagtrabaho at may balik niya sa iyo ang nararapat. Ama, maraming salamat po ng ikapungo ito, Panginoon, ibibigay namin sa iyo ay sa ikalalaganap ng iyong banal na salita. Patawarin mo po kami anuman nagawa na yung pagkakasala at pagkukulang sa iyo. Sa pangalan ng bugtong mong anak na si Jesus. Amen. Amen.
We clap our hands for God. Hallelujah. Amen. Welcome, everyone. Welcome. Will you please say welcome to your sister, to your brother sitting beside you. Welcome. Amen. Okay, or you can fist pump or just tap the shoulder or what's this? Elbow to elbow. Okay? Yeah. Okay. Kids, come on. We're going to pray for you. Wow. Behave si Asyong, ah. Amen. Amen. Here, here. We still have a lot of space here. Okay. Shall we clap our hands for these kids? Every other Sunday, they're presenting a special number. And we're so excited for these kids. Every other Sunday, they're dancing and singing to God. Amen? Let's extend our hands to these people. Lord, thank you so much because you are the God, Lord, who granted us these blessings. Lord, truly, they are our heritage. They are our blessings from heaven. And help us, the parents of God, to bring these kids up in the knowledge and in the fear of the Lord so that when they grow, Lord God, they will never forget all the teachings and all the admonitions of your word. And Lord, we assign angels to them 24/7 to guide them, guard them, protect them. Lord, and all the plans of the evil one and all his schemes will not prosper to these kids because we believe they have, Lord, a great purpose and a great plan. For you know the plans for these people, for these kids, Lord. Plans to prosper them, to make them healthy all the time, to grow, and in Lord God, and to be used for your kingdom. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you so much. Amen and amen. God bless you, kids. Praise God. So, just want to once again welcome our first timer here. Although our church is already, it's been for, I think, 2 years. 2 years already, our church and in here in JRFIM Peel region, but praise God, we just got our church license, amen. So we can now register it to, okay. I think we registered it already, and we are now official to the government. So that's a breakthrough. That's a milestone, amen. After 2 years. No, for two years, I think 18 months already, we've been here in the pandemic. But because of God's grace, hallelujah, tell to your neighbor, because of God's grace, you're still here, amen? Praise God. Hallelujah. So, before I start, I would like you to stand up and let us first welcome the Holy Spirit. Let's bow down our heads. Father, we are so thankful for this afternoon. Once again, we are gathered here to worship you, to honor you, and to obey what you have said in your word to honor the Lord's day. And we are here, O God, worshiping you. Open our hearts, open our minds for your word. And Lord, use me to be the instrument this afternoon. And I promise to bring back to you the glory that is due unto you. Thank you, God, for this wonderful people and this atmosphere of your presence. Touch your people, heal your people, strengthen your people. And for those who are online, Lord, today, your hands, Lord, are not short to reach them, to bless them, and to touch their hearts today, and to transform their lives, Lord. Wherever they are, we believe, Lord God, that you are about to bring blessings to their household today. In Jesus' mighty name, Lord, we bring back to you the glory. Amen and amen. Shall we clap our hands? You can now be seated. So today I'm going to share the third Sunday of our series called Vision. Vision. What is vision? Vision is the dream of the Lord for our lives. How many of you here believe that God has a dream for you? God has placed a dream in your heart. Amen? Amen. It is more than a personal vision or personal dreams. It is personal, but it's not private. What do you mean by that, Pastor? It's the vision of God for your life, the dreams of the Lord for your life, although it is personal. Amen? But it's not private. It means you have a part. Tell to your neighbor, you have a part. Amen. So here in this church, everybody has a part. This church, the vision of this church is, this is the vision of God here in our church, to win souls and to make disciples, to make all people who attends the church to be a disciple and eventually to be a leader of leaders. Amen. So that's the vision. Amen. And our mission is to win people for God. Amen. To win people for God and to teach these people to be closer to God. So that's our mission. And our purpose is to love God and to love people. To love people. Will you please tell to your neighbor, I love you with the love of the Lord. You cannot even stare to your seatmate, huh? Diba? Diba? In our old church, peace be with you, peace be with you. And you're looking for your crush. Peace be with you, hey, peace be with you. Amen? But here, we are loving our brethren. We love our brethren. We love the people of God. And we love the church. Amen. We love our church. This is our church. This is my church. We love this church. We are part of the universal church of Jesus. Although we are local, our church is JRFIM, Jesus Reigns Forever International Ministry, Peel Region. But we are part of the church of Jesus. So whether the name of other church is JIL, Jesus Lord Church, Victory Church, what else? BCF, Victory Christian Fellowship, amen? So we are still part. We are all brothers. In the kingdom of God, there are no cousins. So we are they are not our cousins, amen? They are our brothers as well. Amen. Praise God. But here locally, we belong to one family. Locally, our family is Jesus Reigns forever. So that's the vision of our church, to win souls, to make disciples, to make all disciples leader of leaders. Amen? But for the past Sundays, we're talking about visions, the personal visions of God, the dreams of the Lord for your life. Amen? And today I'm going to share, the title of the message is Dreams and Tests. Dreams and Tests. Psalms chapter 105, verse 17 to 19. If you have your own Bible, we're reading from the New Lorna Tolentino Version, NLT. Okay, I'm just kidding. New Living Translation. I'm always using New Living Translation, but most of the time, I use also New King James Version. Because Old King James Version, although it is the authorized version, it's so deep. The words there, thou, thine, it's not easily understood, it cannot be understood easily. So, New King James is good. Amen? New Living Translation also. And sometimes I use Message Bible or MSG. If you use MSG, no, it will give more taste, right? So, it's also in the Bible. Words are like a modern, amen, the Message Bible. If you have a Message Bible, it's good. You can compare to the Old King James or New King James. Amen. So, let's read verse 17. This is all about the story of Joseph, the visions, the dreams. How many of you here knew about Joseph? Joseph. Joseph, the dreamer, right? Amen? Okay. So, this is all about his story. Verse 17, let's read. Sabay-sabay po tayo, basahin natin. Go. Then, he sent someone to Egypt ahead of them. Joseph, who was sold as a slave. Verse 18, they bruise his feet with fetters and place his neck in an iron collar. Last verse, verse 19. Hello, verse 19. Yan. Until the time, verse 19, mayroon pa yung verse 19, ano? Until the time came to fulfill his dreams, okay? The Lord tested Joseph's character. Oh, yun ang mahalaga dyan, yung verse 19. I think it is there. Verse 19, I will repeat, until the time came to fulfill his dreams, the Lord tested Joseph's character. So dreams and tests are inseparable. You cannot separate dreams and tests. If you have a dream, there will always be a test. Amen. A person experiences trials and hardships in life because he has a dream. He has a dream. Now, Pastor, I don't have a dream, but I still experience trials and testings. So in Tagalog, you're lugi. Lugi ka. Why? Because even though you don't have dreams, you will still experience tests and trials. So it's better for you to dream. Amen? Amen? And please, dream big. Because if you just dream for something like you can accomplish it by yourself, it is not from God. It is your ambition. It's not the vision of God for you. It is just an ambition. Like, I want Pastor to, you know, travel around the world, visit all the beautiful places. Or I want Pastor to go to the moon and step on the moon. Wow, what a dream. Amen? Pastor, someday I want to be the CEO of one of the biggest company here in Ontario. I want to be a millionaire or billionaire someday. That's only your own ambition. You can accomplish it by yourself. But When God puts or place a dream in your life, you need God. Tell to your neighbor, you need God. That, for example, I want to be used by God here in Ontario. God used me in UAE, and praise the Lord, without any boasting, God puts or God established 3 churches there. Hallelujah. And here, when I first came here, God placed a dream in my heart. I remember I was in a big coliseum, and Ben Hinn is speaking, and that, I don't know the name of the church, I forgot, but somewhere in Toronto, we attended a seminar or a conference by Ben Hinn, and he's speaking during that time. It was full packed. About 2,000 people, and I told myself, God, I know in my heart, God spoke in my heart that God will also use me. Wow, Pastor, mapangaraping ka pala. Diba? Dream big. Amen? Amen. Amen. Tell to your neighbor, dream big. Because it's free to dream, right? Amen. Eh, libre na nga mangarap, kami pang mangarap. No? It's free to dream, so dream dreams. Have visions, and these visions are from God. So God put a dream in the life of Joseph. And what is that dream? His dream, you know, he slept during that time, and God visited his subconscious mind. Not all dreams have interpretations. Don't ever approach me and say, Pastor, what is the interpretation of my dream? What is your dream all about? I flew, and then I swallowed a small stone, and I shout Darna, and I became superhero. And then suddenly, a moment after, I swim in a swimming pool, and I woke up because it was wet already, you know. But then, brothers and sisters, there's no interpretation. Probably you are just hungry before you sleep. Okay, that's why you dream those kind of crazy dreams. Amen. But listen, God visited the subconscious mind of Joseph and placed that dream. In that dream, he saw that he was sitting in a throne, ruling his brothers and ruling also his mom and dad. Actually, it was 2 dreams. First, I forgot those dreams, but it is all about Joseph, and the stars bow down, and the moon and the sun also bowed down to Joseph. So it was greatness, right? This dream is all about someday God will use Joseph in a very dramatic way and in a very, great dreams of the Lord for his life. Amen. To become the second in command of the country Egypt. And during that time, Egypt is the USA of the world. The superpower, one of the superpower, if not the superpower, the greatest country in the world. Amen. So now, it says here in verse 19. Verse 19, look. Verse 19, until the time came to fulfill his dreams, the Lord tested Joseph's character. So God tests Joseph's character or Joseph's life for him to be prepared for this dream. God showed that someday he will be a great leader. But before, you know, the space between your present life, to your dreams. For example, this is your dream, the fulfillment of your dream, and this is where you are right now. The space between your dream or your fulfillment of the dream is the test. So your life right now is under a test or series of tests. How many of you here believe that you are already experiencing a lot of tests in life? Will you please raise up your hand? I'm experiencing, Pastor, I'm already experiencing tests in my life, series of tests in my life. So therefore, you are bound to greatness. Amen? Amen? You are about to fulfill your dreams. Amen. The dreams of God for your life. Amen. Listen, your best days are not behind you. Forget the past. Whatever happens in the past, forget it. Because those are behind you. Your great days are not behind you because your great days are ahead of you. You have a bright future in the Lord. Amen. 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 Will you please clap your hands for God? That's why I'm telling you, you need to bring your shades all the time, even though in a, you know, very dark place in the church. Parang ang dilim ng church natin, ano? Anyway, this is not our own, so we're dreaming of our own church. Amen? And we will place a lot of lights so that our place will not be like, you know, dim. Now, I want you to wear shades all the time. If somebody asks you, why are you still wearing shades? You're already inside the house. Tell them, because my future is so bright. I cannot afford to be, you know, in English, ano yon? Masilaw. Ha? Huh? Blinded. Galing ng anak ko ha. Anak, dito ka nga. Interpret my Tagalog, okay? Because we usually speak with her in Tagalog, but she responds in English. So, okay, our kids, let's teach them, even though they're here, let's teach them our language, okay? Our first language. Amen. So just bear with me. I'm not a natural English speaker, but I do believe God will help me. Amen. 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 So don't pray, Lord, please blunt the mind of Pastor. So because I'm already sleepy with this English. Amen. Listen, don't mind my English. Just follow the verses, the teaching of the Lord for us right today. Amen? So vision. Dreams and tests are inseparable. It's like, look at the next slide. It's like, what's this? No. The picture. I want to show you a picture. What's this? Tokwa at baboy. You cannot separate tokwa and baboy, right? You don't know that? You are not eating tokwa baboy? Okay, it's a dish. And you put soy sauce on it. Wow, it's yummy. And the next one is, listen, you can eat them separately, but if you eat them together, wow, the best. Amen? Amen? Look at this next, okay? What's this? No. The dinuguan, and puto. Did you took already your lunch? Not yet. So I didn't take my lunch yet. Dinuguan and puto. You can eat them separately, but if you eat them together, hallelujah. Amen? Perfect combination. Are you still with me? Pastor, you know, I'm so religious, I don't eat dinuguan. Never mind, okay? Next. Chicharon at suka. Lami kaayo. Are you eating this, Crystal? Chicharon at suka? How about you? How about you, sis? Are you eating this? Chicharon? Okay, next picture. alamang and mangga, mango, and what do you call this alamang? Fish sauce, a fish shrimp paste. Amen. Wow. And I love to eat this kind of food, chapati and chai. You know that? Chai and chapati. Wow, that's our breakfast in UAE. It's an Indian food. It's nice. So you can eat them separately, but if you eat them together, it will what? Revolutionize inside. Something is happening inside of you, especially on your tummy. It's like Tom and Jerry's running around. Amen? Amen? Suddenly you become excited. It's like a pregnant na naglilihi. Oh? Craving for something. Pastora, can you please give me a toyo? Hallelujah. Why? Because I'm craving. Amen. Amen. So there's a fulfillment. If you combine dreams and tests. Why? Because test prepares you for your dreams. Amen. Let's repeat this. Test. Come on, test prepares us for our dreams. Amen. Amen. So to put this in just one sentence, look at this next slide. When God, mayroon pa pala ang picture, pandesal and kape. I'm sorry. The cleanest person in the world is Filipino. Ask me why? Because the pandesal or the tinapay or the bread that we eat is already clean. We still want to clean it. In the coffee and wow. Yan ang pinakamalinis. And by the somebody said that Filipinos love, you know, Filipinos is being religious and at the same time loves to eat. Okay? And Filipinos are religious, close to God. Okay? And they love to eat. Why? Because they love lechon. The more you eat lechon, the closer you get to God. Amen. Amen. So please, if you don't want to be closer to God yet, don't eat lechon. Amen. Okay. So to put this in one sentence, when God put a dream or dreams in your heart, you will start to be in trouble. Ouch. Pastor, just talk about dreams. Don't talk about trouble. You cannot separate that because troubles, tests, prepares you for your fulfillment of your dreams. Amen. 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 Have you seen a person who has big muscles? You haven't seen a person with big muscles? Go to the TV, find bodybuilders, okay? Go to YouTube and find those big muscle six packs. And they're, you know, are they just relaxing and being in a comfortable place doing nothing? No, they're always in the gym. Amen. So they develop those muscles not because they're just eating. Pastor, my muscles, my biceps are big. Why? What are you doing? I'm eating like this. The reason why they have this, they develop these muscles is because they're putting work. And they're always in the gym. On my first, I've tried to be in a gym also. And my first week, oh man, all my muscles are cramping and I cannot even lift my hands like that. Why? Because all my muscles are aching. But afterwards, wow, after 1 month, I saw the result. And you can see in my body now. No, I'm just kidding. I stop it. I stop it. Why? Because for me, it's foolishness. No. For other people, they love it, right? Because they want to develop big muscles. Amen. So it's the same. If you want to fulfill your dreams in life, you need to undergo testings and trials. The purpose of trials in your life is for you to be prepared for a big, you know, break or breakthrough. How many of you here wants to have breakthrough in life? Amen. How many of you here wants to experience great blessings in life? A lot of rich kids, after they acquired those wealth from their parents, they live loosely and eventually lose the wealth that their parents, you know, earn. Why? Because they did not experience those trainings, those testings that their parents undergone. Amen. Amen. No, it's so funny when people in Facebook showed something about our, you know, when we're still child, when we're still kids, we played this kind of sports. And if you don't know about this, you're a rich kid. Di ba? It's funny, right? Like Shatong, you know the Shatong? What else? The Jolens, marbles, the techs. Nowadays, kids are playing games in their fingers. That's why they develop muscles in their fingers. Amen. Somebody told me as well that, you know, you can determine, you can identify a smart person, an intelligent person, through their fingers. Why? Because right now, a lot of people are not going to library anymore. They're just staying in the house, you know, Googling. Amen. Searching in the phones. Search in Google, in Chrome. So the wisest person is, right now, your brain is found in your fingers. It's easy, right? If you want to search for something, just Google it. Before you learn something, you need to go to library or you need to enroll in a school. But right now, you just watch in YouTube and you will learn all things that you want to learn. Amen. Amen. So let's go back to vision. Vision is all about the dreams of God in your life. But before you experience the fulfillment of your dreams in life, you will have to face troubles. Trials in life. By the way, troubles and trials and tests are part of our life since when we're still young. No? How many of you here experience tests in the school? A lot. All of us, right? Right? Our grade 1, grade 2 years until grade 6. Until grade 7, 8, and 9, until high school and college, we experience a lot of tests. Amen. So the purpose of those tests is to prepare us for the real test of life. Amen. Amen. Now, tests and dreams are inseparable. By the way, the word test, magugulat kayo, mamamangha kayo. Sa Hebrew word pala, test is charap. That's the Hebrew word. Test is charap. Have you watched the commercial? Charap, charap. Charap, charap. Diba? Amen? In Tagalog or in English, charap, it's delicious. Charap. Wow. That's a Hebrew word, charap. It means charap, or the word charap is, wait, The meaning of this word charap, it means to fuse, that is to refine, to purge, or melt. So charap is the word to melt, to purge, to refine. So the purpose of tests in our lives is to purge, to melt. It's like gold experiencing fire, so that all the dirt and all those unwanted elements in that gold will be removed, so that it will become pure gold. It's like our faith. Our faith is being tested so that our faith will become pure. Pure faith. So that we will grow in our faith. This pandemic, this crisis that we're experiencing right now, you know, and all of those variants, I don't know what are those variants. What I know right now is the Delta variant. Delta variant is here already, right? Amen? Some cases right now are associated with this variant. But don't worry about this Delta, because God is the Alpha and the Omega. Amen? He is the beginning and the end. He allowed this Delta variant, He allowed this COVID-19. You know, the reason is for us, for our faith to be tested. Amen. Me and my family experienced having that variant. What do you call that variant that we got? Yeah, I know, Corona. The variant. I'm talking about the variant. Huh? The UK variant. We got the UK variant. And when we experienced that, you know, the symptoms, it's different from the symptoms of the COVID-19 itself. It's more. It has more symptoms. And I told myself, why is it that this COVID-19 or this sickness came to my body? I'm a pastor. I start to question myself. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I have sinned against God. And you know what? God told me, I'm just testing your faith. Amen. Don't worry about sin. I finished sin in the cross of Calvary 2,000 years ago. Amen. So don't ever, ever be confused with what is happening to you right now. Oh, don't ever, ever say, the reason why I am suffering right now is because I have done something silly in my past. I have sinned against God. So I am just earning this as a consequence, all these problems and trials in my life. Listen, those are just tests. It is just tests for your faith. Will you still believe in God? Will you still hold on to His promise? Will you still believe that God is your healer? Will you still believe that God is your provider? When you are experiencing lack, when you are experiencing those kinds of sickness and disease, will you still believe that God can heal you? Will you still believe that God still has a future for your life? When you say, God, I'm sorry, from now on, I'll be an atheist. I don't believe you, God. Why is it that this happens to me? There's a lot of people that are more, you know, sinners than me. My neighbor are sinners than me. Why are you comparing yourself to your neighbor? He is also experiencing tests. We are all experiencing tests. Three kinds of people that are not experiencing tests anymore. First are the dead people. Second, kids or children. Amen. They don't have problems. They just want to cry if they are hungry. And the parents will just put, you know, milk to their mouth, and then they will start to what? To be happy. And thirdly are the crazy people. They don't have problems. So choose. Are you dead? Are you crazy? Or are you still a kid like Bonjing? Amen. So if you are abnormal, you will experience tests. Now partner those tests with a dream. Hello. Whether you like it or not, you will face trials. So better to have dreams in life. Ask God, God, please give me something that you will do in my future. Show me. That's vision. Suddenly, God will speak to your heart of something that God wanted you to fulfill. Those are visions. Those are the dreams of God. Now, charap means to refine you, to prepare you for your dreams. Now, tests are beneficial for our dreams. Why? Number one, it shows our true quality. Write it down, please. Test shows our true quality. Epictetus says, difficulty shows what men are. You know Epictetus? When these people who are using drugs, do you have Epictetus? Okay, Epictetus is a writer. And he said, difficulty shows what men are. It shows who you are when you face trials. It shows your true quality. Amen. Amen. Your true quality is inside of you. Not until you experience tests and trials. Because tests and trials will lift you up, will show your true self. Amen. If you are strong, then when you face trials, you will still be strong. If you are faithful to God, if you are true worshiper to God, even though this COVID-19 is here, you will still true to God. The reason why people right now, Christians, are not attending the church anymore because of pandemic, they were affected. And before, pre-pandemic, they're going to church. And post-pandemic, they're out of church. They're not going to church anymore. I don't know what's the reason. I don't know what's the reason. They said it's so, you know, risky. But you're going to the mall. You're going to the market, to groceries. But when it comes to church, Pastor, it's so risky there. Come on. The reason why it's because tests exposed your faith, your true self, your true faith. And praise God. Hallelujah. We're still here. Hallelujah. Will you please clap your hands to God? Come on. You are true. Believer of Jesus. There will come a time that Christians will face hardships. Not like this. These are just, you know, sisiw pa po ito. We will face greater challenge, greater trials when it comes to our faith. Amen? Amen. And I read in the Bible that Christians will start to be beheaded because of their faith. Kaya mo ba yon? Kaya mo ba yon? Pastor, bakit wala ka sa church? Pastor, I don't have fare. I don't have money to go to church. I don't have car to go to church. Walk by faith and not by sight. Amen. Do whatever you can for God. Amen. Hallelujah. So if you don't have car, apply for license. And apply for a car loan so you have a car to go to church. Amen. Hello? And you are saying, God, I love you, but you cannot do something for God. That's questionable love. Because true love is demonstrating something to God. Amen. If you truly love God, you need to lift up your hands. You need to worship God out of your strength, might, and with all your heart. You need to show yourself. Sometimes God allows these problems in your life so that your true quality will be exposed. Your true nature will be exposed. If you are an overcomer, then you need trials to overcome. You're telling to yourself, I'm an overcomer, Pastor. Okay, be careful of that word, huh? Because God will start to test you with problems and see if you are really an overcomer. Pastor, I'm more than conqueror. Okay. Pastor, I believe that you are my healer. Okay, I will allow sickness in your body. Pastor, Lord, I know you are my provider. Okay, you will experience lack. I will allow you. God is not the source of poverty and lack. God is not the source of sickness. But He allowed those things for you to be tested so that your true quality will be released and will be exposed. Amen. Praise God. Difficulty shows what men are. Adversity introduces a man to himself. Joseph, look at this chapter, look at this verse, passage from Genesis 37, verse 5. Genesis 37, verse 5. Now Joseph had a dream, and he told it to his brothers, and they hated him even more. Wow. God placed a dream in the life of Joseph, but his brothers hated him all the more. Dapat pa nga magsaya sila, no? They're supposed to be happy for their brother. Because their brother had a dream, had a vision from God. They're supposed to support him, to pray for him, and to help him fulfill the dream that God placed in his heart because they are their brothers. But what they've done is what? They more hated him. Joseph experienced, I will give you 4 P's today. Write it down to your notes. Next time, buy a notebook in Dalarama. Huh? And add a ballpen, okay? So you can put all the notes and you will never forget the message. Why? Because if you are not taking down notes, note takers are history makers. Amen. Number 1 P. The 3 P's or 4 P's of Joseph. Do you know government has 4 P's, right? Our government, the Philippines. But in Joseph's life also, he has 4 P's. Number 1, the pit. Pit. Yan, yan muna. Pit, okay? Pit is the place where his brothers, because they hated him more because of his dream, they thrown Joseph in a well with an empty well, in an empty well. It's a pit. So he experienced a lot of bruises in his body. Amen? And he started to question, why? I'm your brother. Why did you throw me to the pit? Why? Because they hated him all the more. They hated him first because, their father's favorite is Joseph. They are 12 brothers. And the favorite of their dad is Joseph. Jacob, his father, even made a clothing, a special clothing for Joseph. And these 11 brothers did not experience those favor from their father, so they hated him. And then when God placed a dream in his heart, they hated him all the more. So they have decided to throw him to the pit. And let's see, they said, let's see what will happen to his dreams. Huh? You see, huh? You will be someday a great person. Okay, let's kill your dreams from this moment. A lot of people will start to give you problems. Amen. They will be jealous to you because you have a great future in God. Ignore them. These people, although you are with them, but they cannot help you fulfill the dreams of God in your life. Avoid these people. Those people that drag you away from God, they are on drugs. Because they're dragging you away from God. Tell them, you're in drugs. Why? Because you're dragging me away from God. Your peers, not all barkadas, not all friends will help you fulfill your vision. Choose the correct friends. Amen. Amen. Decide to, you know, throw some friends in your life. Why? Because these friends, instead of helping you, they're dragging you. They're pulling you down. Find somebody that will push you, that will help you, that will support you to fulfill your dreams in life. People, God placed people in your life to help you. That's why you're here in the church, because these people will help you fulfill your dreams in life. God made me as your pastor to help you discover your purpose and to fulfill your vision, your dreams, the dreams of God in your life. Magtulungan tayo. Let's help each other. And please, if somebody is promoted or if somebody experienced something that, you know, he's so happy because he got these blessings, rejoice with him. Amen. Huh? Ay, congratulations.
Kala mo kung sino.
I'm blessed with you, brother. Ay, wow, you're promoted. Wow, you got your license. Wow, you got a nice job. And you will start to what? Siraan siya sa ibang tao. You know, the reason why God is in nation. Because like this, because he's so sip-sip in his boss. Eh? Rejoice with your brethren. If he's experiencing success in life, rejoice. If there's, you know, here in Ontario, we have brothers also from Toronto. If they got their new house, we wanted to visit them. Of course, they invited us. Don't go to a party or to a, you know, that you are not invited, right? Or else you will be a party crasher. Huh? Oh, you're here again. Oh, you're here again. Oh, every birthday, every dedication, every house blessing, you are there. Even though you're not invited. But they're inviting me, so I attend their party. Why? And I'm so happy that they got their new house. Amen. And you know, what's my motivation? My motivation is someday, because I rejoice with them, someday I will get my own house. Woo! Amen. Hallelujah. Amen? A lot of people will start to be jealous with you because you have a bright future. Ignore them. Ignore them. Don't dwell on their, on their negative words. Don't be persuaded. Some people will say, "Oh, you cannot fulfill your dreams. Who do you think you are? You are just a fly." Yes, I am a fly. But the moment I sit down on top of the Carabao, I'm already big. Amen. I have God. Although I am just a little person, I am just a nobody, but because I have God, right now, I am somebody. I boast not because I am good, I boast not because I have accomplished something, I boast because I have Jesus. So never mind those words, those negative words. They're just jealous. Amen? Amen? ignore them. So what happened is, of course, these are his brothers. They throw him in the pit. Second P. Potiphar. By the way, that spelling is incorrect. It should be Poti, T-I. Okay? Edit it in your notes. Potiphar. So his name in short is Poti. Poti. Let's call him Poti. Okay? So Poti, you know, Poti is so delicious, huh? In Burger King. Ah, Putin pala yun, Putin. Poti. Potiphar. Potiphar is a man who's one of the highest official of Pharaoh. You know Pharaoh? Pharaoh is the president or the king or the king of Egypt. They called him Pharaoh. So he's the general of Pharaoh, Potiphar. So when these brothers thrown Joseph in the pit, they changed their mind. Now, let's not kill him. Let's just sell him to the Ishmaelites. So the Ishmaelites bought Joseph from his brothers. Amen? And the Ishmaelites sell Joseph to Poti. And Joseph became a slave in the house of Poti. Praise God. You know what happened? Even though he is a slave, the Bible said, because God is with him. Even though you are experiencing a lot of trials right now, the presence of God is with you. God is with you in facing those problems, in facing those trials. Be glad, rejoice. Why? I am experiencing problems right now, but Pastor, God is with me. The more I feel the presence of God, the more trials that I've experienced, the more I experience God. God's hand is with me. Amen. That's what Joseph experienced, because God is with him. So even though he was a slave in the house of Poti, whenever his co-slaves plant garbage, tama ba ako? Cabbage pala, garbage. Cabbage. You know, yung bunga, the fruit of their plant cabbage, it's just cabbage. But when it comes to Joseph, it is cabbage. Whoa. They plant papaya. The papaya tree will produce fruit. And the papaya of the slaves, the other slaves of Poti, are just papaya. But when it comes to Joseph, it's papaya. Ang lalaki. Amen. I saw the kamatis of the neighbor of Sister Jamaica in their house. It's kamatis. I thought it was kalabasa. But it's just kamatis. But it's big. It's huge. Wow. It's so blessed. The neighbor is so blessed. So because God is with him, whatever Joseph does, God blessed. Amen. Amen. I'm telling you, in the middle of pandemic, a lot of people experience blessing.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In the middle of this crisis, a lot of people got their new house.
Amen.
In the middle of this pandemic, I received my blessing from God.
Amen.
Every time I check my mailbox, there is always a check. Hallelujah. What happened? What happened to this pandemic? Huh? It caused me a lot of, not problems, but a lot of blessings.
Amen.
Pastor, I did not experience that. Pastor, siguro ikaw lang, ako hindi. Listen, you're still healthy.
Amen.
You're still strong.
Amen.
You don't have sickness. Amen. You recovered from your sickness. Those are blessings. You just need to recognize those things. You're blessed. Tell your neighbor, you're blessed. Look at your body. You're blessed. It shows. Lucky, oh, lucky. You're blessed. You have a great blessing. God is with you. Tell your neighbor, God is with you. Now, the challenge is be conscious of his presence. God is with you, but you need to be conscious. Not of the devil. Oh, there's a devil here. Oh, no. there's a devil. Why is it that religious people, Christian, are always conscious with the presence of the devil? You know, I've been in a deliverance ministry. I've casted a lot of demons. My first casting out of demons is in our own house. I cast a demon out of my auntie because, you know, she became like this. And somebody told me, oh no, she's experiencing epilepsy. No, that's a demon. And I prayed to her. And then suddenly she spoke, who are you? And she said, I am your lolo. My lolo just died, amen. Really, you're my lolo? And my grandmother who is alive during that time said, oh, mystery. That's the name of my lolo. I told my lola, no, that's not mystery, that's a demon. I cast it out. And praise God, after I cast it out, people are clapping their hands and they said, oh, there's albulario here. That's my first experience casting out demons. From that time on, you know, I became aware of demons. Wow, it's like I'm demon hunting everywhere. When I bless a house, I said to the owner of the house, there's a demon here. Why? I felt something. My balahibo turned up in my nose, amen. Why? There's a lot of Christians, a lot of pastors are conscious of demons. Why? I don't know. But when I learned this, that God is with me everywhere, the presence of God is greater than the presence of demons. So I became what? Conscious of God than conscious of demons. Because greater is He that is in me than he that is in this world. Greater is He that is in you than he that is in this world. So why are you afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Whom shall I be afraid of? Because God's presence with me, God's presence is with Joseph, so he endured trials. And then after Potiphar, you know what happened to Potiphar? Because he was so handsome, although he was a slave, but he is a good-looking slave, suddenly the wife of Potiphar became attracted to him. And sing, oh, lumapit ka, kung gusto mo akong halikan. Di ba? Amen. And Joseph said, no. Please, Madam Poti. You're the wife of Potiphar, and he is my Lord. And he entrusted everything to me, but not you. You are his wife. You are his ownership, not me. I'm sorry. Every day, woo! The wife of Potiphar tempted Joseph. But because Joseph has a dream, temptation has no power. Listen, if you have a dream, if God puts something in you, if God has a vision for your life, if you believe that you have a bright future, avoid temptation. Because it will kill the dream of God in your life. Amen. Praise God. So he said, no, I'm sorry. Naghubad na sa harapan niya. Hindi pa rin niya pinatulan. If somebody will undress, will remove his clothes in front of me, I will pray for him, for her. I'm just kidding. I will run! That's how you avoid temptation. Run! Tell to your neighbor, run. Pastor, I will intercede. No, don't intercede. Pastor, anoint. Lord, anoint my eyes. In Jesus' name. Whatever I see, it's holy, Lord. No, run. There's no pastor, there's no bishop, there's no man of God or woman of God when it comes to temptation. There's no Superman. All of us just run. So Joseph ran, but nahablot ni Poti, o yung asawa ni Poti, some of his clothes. And he used that clothes as to have a revenge because you are rejecting me all the time. I will tell to my husband, you raped me. what you saw, you rape. No, I'm just, it's a joke. What you saw, you rape. Not rape, you rape. So he used that clothing that Joseph owned, and he said to her husband, he raped me. So they put Joseph to what? To prison. The place, actually this prison is for people who offended the Pharaoh or the generals of Pharaoh. This is like a prison, what do you call that kind of prison for special people? It's a dungeon because they offended the Pharaoh and all his generals. So he was placed in that kind of prison where they place what they call that, the fetters in his feet, and something they put it in on his neck. Wow. Praise God. Probably Joseph is starting to ask God, akala ko ba may plano ka sa buhay ko? I thought you have a plan for my life. I thought you have a dream for my life. Why is it that I ended up in prison? And Joseph started to what? To still hold on to God and say, maybe prison is part of my testing. Amen? And one day in prison, because God is with him, wow, the hardest trials in the life of Joseph is the time when Joseph experienced the greatest touch, the greatest presence of God in his life. The Bible said God is with him in Potiphar's house. God is with him in pit. God is with him all the more in prison. Amen. And you know what happened? He was promoted to become the jail guard. What do you call that? The warden of the prison. Naging warden, naging ano siya, pinaka-head of all the prisoners. And one day, the butler and the cupbearer of the king, you know, were placed in prison, and they dreamed that night, and they were in great trouble. Why? Because they don't know the meaning of their dreams. And here comes Joseph. And they ask him, can you interpret my dream? What is your dream? These are my dreams. In short, he interpreted the dream of the cupbearer, and he told, in 3 days, you will be going back to the palace. How about me? I have also a dream. The butler said, what is your dream? There's a basket in my head, and birds are starting to eat on my head. And he said, I don't want you to know this dream, the meaning of your dream. No, just tell me, what is the meaning of my dream? Okay, if you insist, after 3 days, you will be beheaded. You're lying! Sometimes truth hurts, right? Not sometimes, all the time. So, he said to the cupbearer, please, if you reach the palace, tell the king I'm here. And I am not supposed to be here. Please help me. Okay, I will not forget you. But praise God, he forget Joseph. After long years, then Pharaoh got a dream. Amen. Amen. And you know that dream. You read that dream, right? It's all about grains. It's all about cows. And there will be a famine in the land of Egypt, and it will be affected. The whole world will be affected. And nobody can interpret the dream. And the cupbearer, woo, remember Joseph. Amen. Somebody will start to remember you. Ah, si Kumare, I got utang, credit. Oh no, I need to bring back that money that I borrowed, that she lended to me or he lended to me. And then suddenly you will receive an email. Hallelujah. I am your kumari. I'm already rich. I forgot. I still owe you money. I will send you 5 times of what I owe you. Wow. A blessing. Amen? Amen. Amen. Somebody will remember. Tell to your neighbor, somebody will remember you. Hallelujah. How many of you here wants to have that kind of experience? Somebody will remember me to bless me. So, Joseph experienced, you know, Joseph, the cupbearer remembered Joseph, and Joseph was transported from prison to number 4, the last P is the palace. Amen. It's the place of his dream. The place of fulfillment. Someday, you will also be in the palace. Not geographical saying here, but figuratively, someday, God will place you in a place where you will start to fulfill your dreams. Amen. Amen. But you need to experience first pit, then Potiphar, then prison. And after that, your palace. Tell to your neighbor, your palace is coming. Three people, please. Your palace is coming. Your destiny, listen, all of us here has a great destiny. All of us here will experience. Listen, somebody told me that Canada is like Canaan, the promised land. Pastor, why is it that I'm still experiencing like I'm in a desert? I'm already here, but I still experience lack. Probably that person is not yet in the promised land. Because the promised land is not a geographical place. The promised land is a spiritual place wherein, even though you're in the Philippines, wherever you are, if you experience, you know, the promised land, you will be blessed. God will bless you. God will start to fulfill His promises in your life. How many of you here wants to have the fulfillment of the promises of God in our life? Amen? But first, you will experience test. Test. Embrace test. Love test. It prepares you for your great future. From now on, tell God, God, I need more test. How can you pray that? Kunin mo na lang ako, Lord, kung magte-test lang. But listen, that prepares you. The more tests, the greater promotion. The greater blessing. The greater, amen, the breakthroughs in life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! Are you blessed today? Will you please stand up? We will continue this, no? I'm just in my first point. 1,000 points po ito, okay? It's just my first point. Okay, let's pray. Thank you, God. Because we are in the right track. We are experiencing a lot of tests in life. Not only in our personal problems and personal trials, but also, Lord, we are part of this crisis that we are still in. And all our, you know, God, the future is uncertain for us. We don't know what will happen next. But, Lord, it's true that Delta is here right now. But right now, we place our trust in you. You are the Alpha. You are the Omega, the beginning and the end. You don't allow things in our lives without any reason. God, I know the purpose of this is to strengthen our faith, to prepare us for a great breakthrough. Thank you, God, for tests. Thank you, God, for trials. Thank you, God, for all these problems. These are not the result of our committed sin in the past. This is not our consequence. Lord, some are the result of our mistakes in life. But generally, Lord, you allow these problems for our faith to be established. the hardships. Listen, kapatid, sister, brother, your denials, your delays are not your denials. They're just a preparation. God is just preparing you, testing your heart. Probably you are now in the middle of great trials. You're experiencing series of problems. But this is the good news. God allowed that because God is preparing something great for your life. For I know the plans that I have for you, says God. Plans to prosper you. You will experience prosperity. You will experience good health. You will experience breakthrough in life if you hold on to God. If you will not give up, if you will not give in to temptation. As you close your eyes, I want you to be conscious with God's presence today. Somebody here is being touched by God. God is speaking to your heart right now. And God is placing something in you. God is placing something in your heart. I don't know if that is for your own family or if that is for something else. But I do believe if you can accomplish it by yourself, it's just your own dream. But if you need God to accomplish that dream, then it is the visions of God for your life. It is a vision of greatness. Just like Joseph, he received this dream because someday God will use him for greater things. And it involves a lot of people. It involves the whole world. I want you to know that you are part of the greater vision of God here on earth. I want you to know that you are part of God's perfect, great plan in this world. You are special to God. You are a valuable piece in the kingdom of God. You're just a nobody for yourself. But in God, you are somebody. Because you have God. I want you to open up your eyes to God right now. Feel the presence of God. Shall we sing that song, the chorus? I open my eyes.
I want to see your glory.
Let this song minister to you.
Glory,
if you want to lift up your hands to God, come on, lift up your hands.
My heart.
God will start to give you dreams and visions.
Closer,
see what God can do in your life. start to praise you, Lord. We already felt your presence, your tangible presence here in this place. And the moment we hear your word, Lord, something happened in our hearts. Because vision always inspires us. Vision will always motivate us. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you, Lord, for the life of Joseph. We believe, Lord. You have a great purpose, a great plan for our lives. And thank you so much, Lord, for placing that great dream in our hearts today. That's your vision for us. That's your dream for us. And Lord, I pray that the blood of Jesus Christ will cover that dream. And someday, Lord God, someday, Lord, we will experience the fulfillment of that dream. But, Lord, as we journey ourselves toward that dream, we will experience a lot of trials and troubles. But it's okay, God, because you are with us. You said in your word, you will never leave us nor forsake us. And those series of trials, we will use that as a catapult, as an instrument, as a preparation for the great outpouring of your blessings in our lives. Thank you, God. Thank you so much, Lord. We bring back to you the glory that is due unto you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I think we have a special number for the kids. Come on down. Let's clap our hands once again for our kids' ministry. Wala ba kayong kamay dyan? Isa pa pong palakpakan. Praise God! Hallelujah! Dapat ganyan din mga matatanda, no? Talon ng talon! Amen. So next week, Mom and Dad naman, okay? Hallelujah! Okay, announcement. We have some few announcement. Mga lola. Wait. Okay. Next Thursday, not this Thursday. Okay. August 26, we will have our practice here. Thursday, worship team practice. Okay? So, prepare. Those who want to participate in the worship team, come here on August 26, 7 p.m. The church is open for us. We will start to practice so that on September, wow, our own worship team. Praise God for the services of... Will you please clap your hands for our Toronto people? They've been with us for how many years? But praise God, they're part of our, you know, journey. But they're still here. They will still support us, but we need to step up. Okay, we need to do this so that all of us here will have, you know, the sense of responsibility for our own ministry. So, worship team is open. And also, we want people in the multimedia and in audio and in sounds and lights. Okay? And our brethren from Dubai came last week, and they're ready next Sunday. They're here with us. Three families. So we still have a lot of chairs here. So invite more people here in our church. 4 p.m. po. 4 p.m. every Sunday. 4 p.m. Please be early so that we will be early as well. And last, we have our league, basketball league. So everyone is welcome. The families of the basketball players are all welcome. And we can also invite other outsiders. Yeah, it's here every Sunday po, 8 to 10, our tentative gym. I have spoken to Pastor Mike. I told him it's a bit away from here. But it's okay. So this coming tonight, we will have our basketball again. But on next week, I think the league will start. Okay? So invite more people to join our basketball league. And our condition is just attend the basketball league, and let's encourage them also to attend the church. Because here in the church, after we have our service, we will have our eating fellowship. So let's pray for the food before we leave. Stand up. Lord, thank you so much for what... Thank you.